Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, and this is Gogo here from Zhuhai, China. As you can see here, both two cars have green number plates, which means that they are powered by electric. This is Tesla Model 3. It is pure electric car. This one is a BMW 535LE, which is special in China here. It is a plug-in hybrid. So why people here need to buy electric car in China? Because you need to have certain number plate to buy internal combustion engines. This car is from Shanghai. If you want to buy a 530i, which is powered by internal combustion engine, you need to buy a number plate first, which will cost you about 80,000 RMB or $12,000, which is a lot. But by buying a plug-in hybrid, the number plate here is free. So that's the reason why many people would like to buy a plug-in hybrid or a pure electric car in China to save the money to buy the number plate. So let's focus today on this plug-in hybrid 535LE. So as we can see, this is a facelifted 5 series. Why LE? Let's go to the side of this car. This BMW is made in China, right? L stands for long wheelbase. We can see this car is about 10 centimeters longer than the BMW 5 Series manufactured in Germany. And all the space is added for the back seat. As you can see, the back door is quite long, right? Because it is a long wheelbase 5 Series. Now, let's have a look at the back seat first. So now I'm sitting in the back seat of 535LE. Remember, this is a long wheelbase car. We can see that the leg room here is a lot, just like a 7 series, to be honest. You may ask, Chinese people are not very tall. Why they want a long wheelbase car? Because most Chinese households, they only have one car, so they want the car to be as big as possible. And many people need to sit in the back of a 5 Series. So the back space here in the 5 Series is very, very important. Lots of knee room, lots of headroom, and you even have a Maybach style headrest here. It is super comfortable to sit in the back seat of a 535LE. Now let's talk about some technical detail of this 535LE. As you can see, here is a internal combustion engine, a 2.0 liters turbocharged petrol engine, and it's powered by one engine and one electric motor. Together, it can produce 215 kilowatts and 420 newton meters of torque. This power is extremely the same as the Tesla Model 3. However, because the 535LE is more heavier, it can go from not to 100 kilometers per hour in 6.7 seconds. I think that's enough for us for in-town driving. And moreover, it has a 17 kilowatt hour battery, and you can charge it from 0% to 100% in 4 hours. Please be mentioned that this car can only use slow chargers. It cannot use the fast charger. And for pure electric range, based on NEDC estimation, this 535LE, together with the 17 kilowatt hour battery, can go 94 kilometers from 100% to 0%. However, that's based on NEDC estimation, which will overestimate the real-world range. For this 535LE, the real-world range should be around 60 kilometers. Do you think that's enough? Please comment down below. So another thing that is very special for this 535LE, because it's plug-in hybrid, we have a charging port here on the driver's side. So as you can see, this is a small, slow charging port. You cannot use the fast charging station like this, and you can only charge it at home for about 4 hours to be fully charged this car. So now let's move into the interior of this 535LE. As you can see, this interior is basically the same as the 5 series, the normal 5 series, as well as the 5 series manufactured in Germany. Nothing special here, but as a facelifted 5 series, we can see that the screen here in the center console is huge, and the responsiveness of this screen is perfect. Resolution is perfect, nothing to complain about. And iDrive system is also one of the best infotainment system, I believe. And this is a M-Sport package. We have this very comfortable and sporty steering wheel. I like this steering wheel very much. And of course, as a 5 series, it's a huge car. You have lots of space here for your cup holder, and we also have a wireless charging pad here in the front. Right, it's really comfortable sitting position here, nothing to complain about that. It's a really good car to sit inside here. So next part I would like to talk about is the driving experience of this 535LE. So as a plug-in hybrid, it has three modes. The first one is pure EV mode. Under pure EV mode, this car will be 100% powered by electric motor, and the internal combustion engine will not start. Under this mode, you may find that the power is not enough. But for in-town driving, I think there's no problem for pure EV mode. I think most people will use this car under the second mode, which is hybrid mode, right? The computer will decide when to start the internal combustion engine. If you press the gas pedal quite hard, it will automatically start it. When it does not need the internal combustion engine, it will shut it automatically. And the next mode is sport mode. Under sport mode, this car will turn on its internal combustion engine all the time to give you the best responsiveness of the acceleration. So I think under hybrid mode, that's my favorite. This car feels very, very, very quiet, and the NVH control is perfect here. Much better than Tesla's, I think. And the driving experience of a BMW is always perfect. Nothing to complain about that. And the sporty steering wheel gives you a very sporty feeling of steering as well. And also the gas pedal is very responsive, and the acceleration is linear in this car with the, you know, the ZF880 automatic transmission. It works perfect, nothing to complain about that. And also the suspension is very comfortable because this car is heavier than a normal 5 series. And the suspension can feel a little bit even more comfortable than a normal 5 series. Okay, so I think that's all I would like to share about the driving experience. However, not everything about this 535LE is good. Now, let's talk about a huge disadvantage of this 535LE. As we can see the badge here at the back, a special L here. You can only see this in China, because a L stands for long wheelbase, right? Of course, it's powered by electric tailgate. Let's have a look at the trunk here. You can see here's a huge steer. At the back is the battery of this plug-in hybrid 5 series. It has a 17 kilowatt hour battery. It's quite big. You need to find some place to put it. And BMW put it in the back of this car. So the capacity of this plug-in hybrid 5 series is no way good as the normal 5 series. And it has no space here, but when you lift up this case, it becomes a flat floor in the trunk, but the height is terrible. So the capacity of the plug-in hybrid 5 series is not good at all. Okay, let's close this tailgate. So now let's have a conclusion about today's video. I talked about this 535LE made in China plug-in hybrid 5 series. And for Tesla, it is a pure electric car. Which kinds of electric car do you prefer? A plug-in hybrid or a pure electric car? So in my own opinion, because the infrastructure of charging station is still under improvement, we have lots of petrol station instead. So with a plug-in hybrid, if you can have a petrol station, you will have no range anxiety, right? But for Tesla, like this pure electric vehicle, you have certain range anxiety. So I think plug-in hybrid under certain condition, it will be a better choice than a pure electric car. And moreover, I think many of you may be the first time to notice that there's a long wheelbase version for 5 series, right? Actually, in China, we have long wheelbase version for 3 series. For A4, Audi A4, we have A4L, we have even A6L. And what's your idea about this long wheelbase car? And I don't know why these vehicles, long wheelbase vehicles, have not been exported to foreign countries. Do you think you will purchase a long wheelbase 5 series or 3 series in your own country if these cars are on sale there? Please let me know your idea and comment down below. Okay, so that's all for today's video. If you enjoy watching it, please like it, share it, and comment down below about any suggestion you have. Also, please follow my video. And for the next week video, I will upload the review of new ES8. And later in the future, I will also reveal more EV that is made in China. Thank you for your support. See you soon. Bye.